Please be seated. Professor Marie Wilson, Chief Academic Services Officer, Senior Management and Staff of the University, graduates, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. As Chancellor of the University of South Australia, I'm delighted to welcome you here this morning to this graduation ceremony. At the outset, I acknowledge that this ceremony is taking place on Kaurna land. The Kaurna people have performed ceremonies on this land for many centuries, and we pay respect to their living culture and the unique role they continue to play in the life of the Adelaide region. Graduands, let me be the first to officially congratulate you on being here today and on getting your degree, and for overcoming all of the obstacles that life has thrust at you to receive it here on this day and in this place. After all your hard work, you now face a future like few others before you. It is a future with some challenges, but one with some extraordinary possibilities. But you have prepared well. You have proven to be adaptive, responsive, and flexible. And if you've chosen a career that you're truly passionate about, amazing things will happen, because you will find that hard work isn't really hard work at all. The past year has taught us many lessons, but it has given us all a renewed sense of community and an opportunity to display the kindness, compassion, and sensitivity that we're all capable of. Many of you have already demonstrated how strong and resilient and open to possibilities you are as you quickly and easily moved your studies and work offline, online, I should say, in the face of a public health emergency. That's the very sort of resilience that employers look for. Proof that you can and will adapt to changing circumstances. Proof that learning is so important to you that you will continue to learn under any circumstances. Proof that your attitude and work ethic gives you the freedom to work independently. And proof that you'll let nothing stand in the way of achieving what you set out to achieve. I would add to that the soft skills that you bring to your new career environment will make all the difference. How we deal with challenges, how we support others deal with challenges, makes us who we are. We all have a duty to look out for our colleagues and to treat them well. I'm certain that one of the keys to your success, which has led you here today, has been the love, support, and encouragement of those closest to you, your family and your friends. I'm sure you're all aware, as am I, that without this support, you would not be here today. Graduands, to demonstrate your appreciation and to thank your family and friends for their invaluable contribution, I ask that you stand up, face your loved ones, and give them a big clap and cheer. Thank you, graduands. It is now my pleasure to ask our Chief Academic Services Officer, Professor Marie Wilson, to address you.
Good morning and welcome to your graduation ceremony, and congratulations on being here. We know you have worked long and hard to finish your degrees, and that graduations are an important part of your passage into the next stage of your lives. And so we all sit here, sanitized and physically distanced still, and ready to give you the appropriate send-off. You are different people now. The world you knew as you began your degrees has changed, and so have you. During the course of your degree, we've all developed new ways of being. For a while there, we had just one aim in mind, to protect ourselves and each other from possible harm. And from the travails of 2020, from the fires to the pandemic, we have learned some new lessons. We've learned to value help and the support that we give and receive. We've learned to be agile, to be creative, to sidestep obstacles, and to build better solutions. We've had time to pause, to think, to reflect and contemplate the person we want to be and the place we want to take in the world. Two of the most impactful changes that stand out for me are the care, concern, and consideration we have shown for one another, and that global collaboration on many levels, governmental, organizational, and scientific, has led to an incredibly accelerated response to a pandemic that touched us all. And yes, there are some setbacks, as you'd expect, but we're rapidly making our way back in what some term the new normal. And here, today, you take another step into that newly minted way of working and being. This is the day we congratulate you and wish you well as you begin your future careers. This is the day that makes all the difference. It's the day of our shared success. Yours in receiving the parchment you have worked so hard to get, and ours for steering you through the past few years, passing on the knowledge that you need, and then ensuring that you can practice your craft capably as you pursue your dreams and aspirations. This marks our 30th anniversary of doing just that for the hundreds of thousands of students who have crossed the stage. And one aspect remains true of every graduation ceremony. Graduates taking fresh, new credentials and enormous hope into a world alive with possibilities. For 30 years, they have been the innovators, enterprising professionals, and critical contributors who power our economy and change our world. They are the people whom you will join in the months and years ahead to do your part in pursuing your dreams and advancing society and your community. Together, I cannot think of a group of people more able to rise to the challenges ahead than the group gathered here today. You have not only been given a solid base on which to build your future career, but you now have the added ability to turn obstacles and challenges into opportunities. Each of you has a history with challenges and travail. Some things have been lost and others broken. Remember now and as you live your life that there are many beautiful things that can arise when things are a bit broken. I am a quilter. I take old cloth, often torn but full of memories, and make quilts held together by sewing and embroidery that are beautiful and useful. Gardeners turn debris into compost and cutting and seeds into beautiful gardens full of fruit, vegetables, and flowers. Broken tiles and plates become mosaics in many cultures, or in Japan may take on a new life altogether, bound with precious metal in an art form known as kintsugi, or golden repair. Repair is the essence of resilience. Our bumps and breaks, our setbacks, temper our resolve and lead us to savor success all the more. In Leonard Cohen's anthem, he wrote, "There is a crack in everything. That's how the light gets in." Through our unique experiences, we are able to leverage our resilience and what we have learned to craft a better future for ourselves, our families, and our world. That's how the light gets in. So as you cross the stage today, hear your name and every clap and cheer as affirmation of your achievements and your future. And each of you enjoy the light. On behalf of the University of South Australia, I wish you every success, every joy, and great fortune for the years to come. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Wilson. I now invite Professor Andrew Beer, Executive Dean, UniSA Business, to begin the presentation of awards.
Chancellor, I present to you the candidates who have fulfilled the conditions for admission to awards of this university. I request that awards to be conferred in absentia upon the other candidates whose names appear in the graduation ceremony handbook.
Professor Beer, I have pleasure in conferring awards on all candidates who have complied with the prescribed requirements.
For the Graduate Certificate in Business Administration, Tyson Barolo. And Bethany Lee Wilsmore. For the degree of Bachelor of Accounting, Kate Jessica Burfield. Kelly Clifford. Olivia Ellie Irma Crowhurst. Fabian Davis. Erin Jane Forey. Rebecca Fox. Chloe Alice Hitman. Abdallah Om Gel. Jenny Marie Jones. Katie Lee McMillan. Jennifer Menzies. William John Moore. Shendi Russell. Michelle Thomas. Belinda Ann Tildesley. And Hadia Zahr. For the degrees of Bachelor of Business Economics, Finance and Trade and Bachelor of Business Financial Planning, Cooper McRae. For the degree of Bachelor of Business Economics, Finance and Trade, Madeline Michelle Gallen. Marinos Manny Katapodis. Mary Caius. Richie Meach. John Yanni Pappas. Angus James Parker. Cody Agnesi Pilkington. Lachlan James Potter. Arvind J. Ravindran. Alexander Stidiford. Nathan James Tripodi. Tuan Chung. And Stefan Alexander Wokel. For the degree of Bachelor of Business, International Business, Donovan Edward Jack Pollock. For the degrees of Bachelor of Commerce Accounting and Bachelor of Media Arts, Michael Lanzilli. for the degrees of Bachelor of Commerce Accounting and Bachelor of Business, Sport and Recreation Management, Isaac Mancillis. For the degree of Bachelor of Commerce Accounting, Precious Akam. Maddie Louise Ballinger. Shahnaz Bakiri. Liam James Carlson. Madison Elise Carnegie Smith. Hulin Chin. Zachary Zen Lung Chung. Vanessa Coppola. Samantha Crossman. Zore Farian. Adam Samuel Gentlecore. Lisa Grace Gerasitano. Nicholas James Gleason. Zach Kumar Gupta. Emmanuel Olarisis. Jasmine Jade Harding. Jake Cameron Hartigan. Stephen James Hilliard. Brendan Ian Jericho. Rhys Nicholas Jones. Billy Karapetis. Cameron Paul Kelly. Brock Kohlberger Masson. Nicholas Cruz Lambropoulos. Bianca Lombardo. Lewis Andrew March. Liam Cameron Marusi Marks. Vimbai Masariyara. Sarah Madison Mitchell. Fan Mo. Jessica Kate Morgan. Michael David Miles. Tiwin Zhao Nguyen. Carly Lee Nickel. Justin Carl Nikolai. Stefan John Paletto. Alexandra Kate Pearson. Edwina Harriet Roger. Lachlan Rowenfeld. Patrick Ryan. Joshua Lachlan James Silwood. Dan Srower. Michael Sisman Suski. Harrison Mitchell Tager. Harrison Allen Thornton. Lachlan John Waters. Yuxin Wei. Emma Lorraine Wheeler. Yufan Zhang. And Hao Zhang. Chancellor, this concludes the presentation of awards.
Thank you, Professor Beer. Graduates, you have shared one of the most significant periods of your life with your colleagues at the University of South Australia. You have worked hard and earned a degree from one of the world's best young universities. I know that in whatever your field of expertise, that you will make a valuable and lasting contribution, and that you will take your part in a rapidly growing network of UniSA-inspired success stories who are all doing interesting and good work throughout the world. While on the subject of UniSA success stories, today we are assembled in the cultural and sporting heart of the university, Pridham Hall, and this is where we celebrate all of our successes, including yours here today. This building was made possible by a successful alumnus, a man named Andrew Pridham. Andrew graduated and went on to make his mark upon the world, first in property management and then in investment banking. He was keen to contribute to UniSA's vision for the future and subsequently made the single largest philanthropic donation to the university, which was used to build this magnificent building. Andrew graduated from us with all of the attributes that you graduate with today. You have the qualifications, and coupled with a passion to do something positive, you can make real change in the world. I very much hope that you continue to stay in touch with us and let us know what you're up to. You can do this through our alumni network, which now has close to 250,000 members. It is there to support you and give you that connection back to your university. As you leave us here today, I wish you a world of opportunity and good fortune. But before you go, please stay seated while the rest of us in this assembly stand to congratulate you and wish you well on your journey.